A few years ago, there was a controversy regarding the habits of pro wrestling trainer Bill DeMott, which, based on the reports, bordered on abusive. In a Shoot interview, I recall Rikishi saying that he prefers building up his students' confidence. Now, I'm paraphrasing what he said, but it was to the extent of when you walk into the academy, you already have my respect because it's a tough business. Given that I believe that respect is a two-way street and is not the same as reverence, that sentiment stuck with me and my preferred approach as a DM. It's this mindset that's at the core of my disdain for the so-called X card and the recent consent form from Monte Cook Games. Now, I briefly brought up the X card during Wrestling Month, but at the time I wasn't able to go into detail about what it was. Simply put, it's a card, or similar identifier or trinket, that someone can hold up during a gameplay session when they're feeling uncomfortable. That alone I found contentious, but then Monte Cook releases a PDF called a consent checklist, which prompts the dismusing. Let me open by saying I don't have any ill will towards the creation of these trinkets or those who choose to use them. I'm sure it comes from a good place, wanting people to not feel singled out at the table. But as the adage goes, there's nothing like a good cause to bring out the worst in people. As I said at the start, I believe respect is a two-way street. If you want it, you gotta give it. When someone comes to my table, that person is sending a message that they trust in my ability to run a certain campaign. Because of that respect given to my abilities, I try and make clear through primers and a lot of pre-gaming what the game's tone is and what I expect of the players. Ideally, in that situation, everyone wins because nobody is above the others. Though again, I need to make clear that this is referencing an ideal situation. In the same vein, I respect the people at the table enough that if they have an issue or suggestion in the campaign, they can come to me through either DMs or just calling me up. Being a GM is a tricky affair at the best of times, especially in my case, given how I try to be very hands-on with my players. Having people fill out a form that assumes they cannot simply tell me something's over the line feels like I'm assuming the worst either from them, because it seems like I'm talking down to them and effectively babying them, or myself, because why else would I be so cautious about someone's feels if I didn't have something that was going to offend them? That's obviously not the case, but it's easy to make that kind of judgment. That's the reason I don't care for either the X card or the consent form. I prefer to treat my players like adults. To presume that they need some apparatus or form to demonstrate comfort or discomfort, put bluntly, I have no interest in babying or even using the bigotry of low expectations at my table. In an age where everybody is made to be afraid of their shadow, lest they offend the emotionally immature, it's my job to provide an escape from this, a place where someone can hang their hats and have fun. After all, I consider my monastery the open bar of the internet, as I've said multiple times. How can I do that by presenting the same apprehension in the rest of the world? As a final note, I'd like to read something that one of my good friends Nefenor had stated on Twitter. I'm going to sum up consent in tabletop RPG, and I guarantee you it's the most simple and rational thing you've ever heard. Here it goes. If you sit down at the table, you're consenting to play a game. If you don't like what is happening in the game, you can get up, excuse yourself from the table, and have the GM's consent to never come back. If you want to discuss something with the GM about something that makes you feel uncomfortable, do it privately, calmly, and like an adult. If the GM isn't able to make it work for you, then you can leave, as in just you, privately. The GM can be an adult and just say you didn't like how the game was progressing, which is true, and that can be it. Turning it into a public drama is something only a narcissist would do, an abusive person, a controlling person. So take your foul outrage and go home. No one wants the game dominating narcissistic, abusive drama llamas in their game. So if you feel the need to bring up your discomfort publicly, you are the problem, not the GM. And I assure you, a good GM always finds new players. A bad player will have a hard time finding GMs. If GMs feel the need to hand out consent forms for players to fill out, then it's obvious those players aren't really friends. Real friends know where the line is. The fact that they feel the need to do this shows they are literally scared of the players throwing a temper tantrum. That means the GM is literally the slave of his players. And you know what? As a GM, I didn't consent to that. And I'm never going to consent to that. I've had characters of mine kidnapped and tortured, and we left what kind of torture up to the imagination. In fact, the game where those two things happened, to the same character, was one of the best games ever. Even though I spoiled the GM's plans with that tortured character. If you can't handle adult themes in your tabletop RPG, then maybe you shouldn't be playing an adult game. Try Toon. And no, I am not kidding. Try Toon. It's an older TRPG, I have the early edition of it on my shelf, and it's literally like playing Looney Tunes. Safe, fun, and no scary adult things. Stay frosty.